quick one today. I'm out on the road in Western Australia. Not that I've done anything for a few months in between. I just have been keeping busy. So enjoy. Hopefully I'll get another one of these up sometime soon. See you at the end for the end notes. So a few months back, we had a bit of demonstration around Australia. I'm sure most of you heard of it, from a little group claiming to be trying to reclaim Australia, which, given that none of their spokespeople were actually Aboriginal, I'm not sure who they're trying to reclaim it for. Really, in the end, they just turned out to be neo-Nazis. And it seems they had confused Australia for Germany, circa 1938. And so some people showed up and did a counter rally, and then they sort of went away, and we hoped that was that, and that was done. But then they showed their head again, like a dirty, racist Hydra. And it's a bit disappointing for everyone. I mean, they don't quite really seem to know what they want, except they know they want it to be white. Twice in their little manifesto, they claim they want to preach separation of religion and state, but actually most of their complaints are actually about wanting things to be Judeo-Christian. This doesn't seem very separate to me. I mean, they say they want equality and tolerance of races and religions, but they are blatantly attacking Islam. So for example, they want to abolish halal certification, yet they have no issue with kosher certification. Even though they are essentially a very similar process, it's pretty much the same thing, just one comes from a predominantly white group, and the other a less than white group. Yet at the end of their declaration, they do declare, "We are a mongrel nation, and all parts need to be recognized for what they added." You know, unless those particular parts happen to be not white. They try really hard to hide behind things that they can't be argued with. For example, women's rights. They talk a lot about women's rights, and they talk a lot about indigenous rights, though they don't really feel that that needs to be elaborated on, like all their other points. Yet, I don't see them showing up at Parliament to put in place, say, Aboriginal land rights, or to get systems in place to help stabilise the Aboriginal community, or to help reduce incarceration numbers amongst the Aboriginal community. And finally, they claim to defend service uniforms, like Army, Navy, and the flag, claiming that an attack on our flag must be made punishable at law. Yes. Punishable at law. Anyway, they don't seem to realise that we don't really care too much about the flag. Unless, of course, you're an Indigenous athlete and you're trying to show pride in your heritage. Then we care. Then we care a lot. No. As average Australians, we really only care about the flag enough to recognise it and to accessorise with it when it comes to, you know, Australia Day. I mean, really, really. And if you want to protect the flag, you'd have to ban it from being worn as a cape, wouldn't you? I mean, converting regular bogans into super bogans. Their true power comes from exposure to a sunburned country. Your only weakness is tolerance. Now, some more prominent Australians have noticed that their outward expressions don't seem to mesh with their proclaimed intention.
Singer Jimmy Barnes has told protesters to stop using his band's songs at demonstrations. They were played at anti-immigration rallies at the weekend.
They truly thought that they could get Scottish immigrant Jimmy Barnes to agree to allow them to spread their sort of anti-immigrant propaganda, their anti-tolerance propaganda. It's just mind-boggling. Like, and what song did they use? Perhaps the Ballad of the Blue Collar Everyman, Working Class Man. No. Or, seeing as they're protesting this sort of immigration, integration, maybe they're using a clever quip by using "You got nothing I want." Yeah, kind of funny, making a joke, being intolerant. No. What they went with was K-Sun. That's right, a song about a disillusioned Australian soldier returning from a war that he was forced into by his country, only to find that he didn't call Australia home anymore. In fact, nowhere feels like home anymore. So he takes the last plane out of Sydney for anywhere else. Jimmy was not happy. Now, pissing off Jimmy Barnes is about as un-Australian as it gets, guys. It's sort of like kicking a kangaroo while wasting a beer and referring to soccer as the one true football. No. Pissing off Jimmy Barnes is like pissing off Vegemite. And it's not just Barnesy that they've been banned by. There's an increasing list of artists who are coming out and saying that they would prefer if Reclaim Australia didn't use their songs at their rallies. People like Midnight Oil, John Farnham, Goanna, Red Gun, Lee Kernaghan, even rapper 360 has released a track about how racist Australia is. And this is a guy who, if you would ask the wrong liberal lefty, would be accused of cultural appropriation. Don't worry, 360, I'm there with you, I do stand up, and that's as American a form of art as there is, really. So, I thought I'd do the guys at Reclaim Australia a bit of a solid. And I put together a little list of potential songs that they could use at their next rally. So here we go. Anything by Rolf Harris. Yeah, so you've been turned away by this one Aussie icon, and that's sad. That's really sad. Here's another Aussie icon that we really don't want anymore. You can have him. Whatever that means to you. Kevin Bloody Wilson, Living Next Door to Alan. This little homespun ditty reminds us not only of our racist past and attitudes, big tick for you guys, but that there was also a time where someone could make a pretty solid living spewing this sort of crap. And finally, Joe Dolce, Shut Up at Your Face. Seems to be on around the same level as you guys. So enjoy those. Alright. So that was Reclaim Australia. Just want to clarify a couple of things. I remember talking about halal and kosher and saying that they were pretty much the same thing. I know that they are not pretty much the same thing. There are similarities, but there are just as many differences. I'm just going to put that out there now. My apologies for that one. Okay. So, music that we were listening to, I only picked one track for this one, and that is 360s On a Planet No One Knows. Seems the most appropriate for this particular episode. Hopefully we won't have any issues by using it. Find out, I guess. Might be back here re-recording this at some point. Alright, so we're just gonna end on 360. Planet No One Knows.
All I'm trying to do is educate you more. That ain't the way we're supposed to exist. Now I'm on a planet where nobody lives. To try how utopians think. We don't change the tone of our voice, but the tone of your skin. Even though I want you near.